Hello everyone. In this video, I'd like to show you how to set up a thermostat's generic function. And for this exercise, we're going to set up the generic function to act as a branch room cooling. So we're going to open up a solenoid and that will assist in cooling down the branch room. So the P-rack can control the racks as well as be an additional branch room cooling controller. So as a reference, this is alarm button, program or menu button, escape or back button, up, enter, and down. So let's go into the program. And we need to insert our password. And I would like you to use the manufacturer's password, which is 1234. And this will allow us to set up this generic function. So let's enter. So in the main menus, let's go down to menu E, other functions, and enter. Then in the submenus, let's go down to submenu F, which is generic functions, and enter. So here's the two different kinds of generic functions that you can set up: thermostats and modulations. So we want to set up our thermostats. So let's enter. So you have a maximum number of 5. But let's just enable one for this exercise. So I'm going to enable number one. Leave the rest all disabled. And let's go down. So generic stage number one, regulation variable. So what would you like the PREC to look at? So what variable does it need to look at to switch on and off your function? So let's enter. So you have a couple of options. You have power percentage compressors, which the controller can look at. Power percentage fans, line one. Regulation percentage compressor, line one. Regulation percentage fans, line one. Zero variable one, or zero variable two. So I'd like you to use zero variable one. We don't have a secondary variable that we're going to look at, so we're only going to use one probe. And my mode is going to be direct. So if we go down, generic stage number one, enable. So you have the option for a heartbeat. I'm not going to choose a heartbeat, I'm going to leave that disabled. And your description, you can either skip the description or you can enter a custom description. Just show you. So custom and enter. Now I have the option to give it a name. So we can make it, let's go up, and you can name this now plant room cooling. So for this exercise, I'm just going to write plant. Plant. And then when you have a look later on and the next technician comes on site and he doesn't know what this generic function does, the description will tell him this is plant room cooling, and then he'll immediately know. If you skip it, it's always just going to be generic function number one. So plant, just a T. We skipped the T. Let's just go, oh, there we go. Perfect, plant. So let's just go all the way to the back. Okay, so now we've named it plant. So let's go down. Now we have a set point. I'm gonna make my set point 20 degrees. Okay. And for a differential of 2. Perfect. So let's go down. Now we have some high alarms. So you can enable a high alarm. And my high alarm, I'm gonna make it 30 degrees. It obviously is dependent on you as the commissioning technician. You have a delay time. I'm going to put in a little bit of a delay time, maybe 60 seconds. And my alarm type is normal. You can also make it serious to click your alarm relay if you assigned one, but I'm gonna leave it normal for now. If we go down, now you have a low alarm, which you can enable and have some set points. I'm gonna leave this disabled. Okay, so let's go down. Okay, and now we're back at the beginning. So now we've set up the generic function in the generic functions setup, but we are not done. So now we have to go and select that serial variable one that we said it must look at. Now we must go to the inputs and outputs menu. So let's go back to the main menus and go to menu B, inputs and outputs, and enter status, enter analog inputs, option B, and enter. So if we go up, I'm gonna look for generic analog input one, and I'm gonna assign it according to my wiring diagram. Or if you're doing this as an addition later, you would know, okay, I've put my probe on U7 and it's a normal NTC. And now you have a reading, there's no calibration. Okay, so now the controller knows what input to look at. Now we need to assign the output. So if we go back one, and we go down to digital outputs. Now we're gonna assign the output, which is actually gonna click our solenoid. So if we go down, there's our compressors, fan, and generic stage number one. And I'm gonna enter, and then I'm gonna assign it randomly to digital output number six. It's gonna be a normally open, and the function is not active. And there you go. So that is how we set up a generic function as a plant room cooling. So now the controller will look at our serial variable one, which is our input that we assigned. And it will click our relay on the controller to start the cooling. Thank you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.